Hello everyone. Today I'm going to present one of the advanced topics in the textbook written by the famous writer in the areas of econometrics. The topic is instrumental variables estimation and two-stage least squares. And in order to easier to digest the chapter, the concept, the techniques, and apply the concept, the technique in the real data set, I will use the data programming software R to digest, or you are to digest real data set. The data set comes from the paper in the Journal of Econometrics. It's a title, Semi-parametric Instrumental Variables Estimation of Treatment Response Models by Professor Abadis. As the data set come from the Utrecht data set, and the professor Arabis obtained these data from the 1991 survey of income and program participation. With the data set, the equation of interest is a linear probability model. Yeah. And the target is to test whether there is a trade-off between participating in a 400K plane. I mean a P400K. P400K is one if participate in 400K. Test whether there is a trade-off between P400K and having an individual retirement account, IRA, here, PISA. So we want to activate the beta one. PISA is one if have the individual retirement account. And in the equation, here's the income, the annual income, and here's the age in years. And 400K plans is an employer respond divided contribution pension account divided in subsection 400K of the Internal Revenue Code. And we want to estimate the beta one to test whether there is a trade-off between the P400K and having an individual's retirement account, I mean PISA. So the first step is to estimate the equation by OLS and discuss the estimated effect of P 400K. And the second step is that to discuss problem with the OLS. And the third section will focus on provides explanation what is required for the E400K to be a valid IV, which stands for the instrumental variable for the 401K. And E401K is a binary variable equal to one if a worker is eligible to participate in 400K. And the next session, we will estimate the reduced form for P401 K and verify that the E401K has significant partially correlation with the P401K. Use the heteroscedasticity robust standard error. And the next step is to estimate the structural equation by the IV. I mean the instrumental variables and compare the estimate of beta 1 with the OLS estimate and should obtain the heteroscedasticity robust standard errors. And the final section is to test the hypothesis that P400 and case is in fact exogenous using the heteroscedasticity robust test. Now I will perform processing the real data set by all first and also go over six sections mentioned here. Here's data programming software R. The first step is to use the package. AER, and loading required packet car is a LM test, etc. And use a command to use the data set 400 and K, 400, 1 and K subs in the Utrecht data set. The first one is to check the relevance reduced form. Here's the reduced form, the dependent variables, and the OLS, dependent variables and independence, E401K. And now with the OLS, OLS with dependent is pizza, dependent variables is pizza. I mean having the individual retirement account. Here P401K income. and then IV estimation, I mean instrumental variables estimation. With the command. And we also estimate the reduced form for P400 and K and verify E400 and K has significant partial correlated with P401K. Using the heteroscedasticity robust standard error. So with the comment. Now we have the heteroscedasticity robust standard error. Yeah. And estimate the structural equation by IV and compare the estimate of beta 1 with the OLS estimation. Again, obtain the heteroscedasticity robust standard errors. And testing the endogeneity of explanatory variables. In this situation, we obtain the reduced form regression already. To obtain the reduced form residuals, V2, right? And S V2 to the structural equation. To the structural equation and run OLS residuals from the first state regression. By using R, we can use the command. The first day is a reduced form already. Now we do the second stage. By adding the residuals in the first day and as the reduced form residuals to the structural equation and run OLS. By using the command, adds the residuals of the reduced form in the first state, right? And run the OLS. Now we processed the real data already. And we will focus on different questions. related to the case study. The first one is to estimate the equation by OLS and discuss the estimated effects of P401K. So we already estimate the equation by OLS. And here's the intercept. Minus 0.188 and the beta one is 0.054, right? And discuss the estimated effects of P401 case. I mean, discuss comment about the number 0.054 by the OLS estimate. And you can see that the coefficient on P400NK is here's 0.054. Implies what? Implies that participating in 400NK planes is associated the beta 1 hat implies that participation in 400NK plane is associated with 0.054 higher probability of having an here's the pizza having an individual retirement account holding incomes and age fixed holdings income and age fixed the second one. What is the potential problem with the OLS? For the purposes of estimating the ceteris paribus trade-off between participation in two different types of retirement saving plans, what may be a problem with ordinary least squares? So we can research the paper. In the section, the paper mentioned that individuals who participate in such programs have stronger preferences for saving. So that even in the absence of the programs, they would have saved more than the people who do not participate. And even after controlling the effects of observed determinants of saving, such as age and income, unobserved preferences for saving may still contaminate comparison between participants and non-participants. And we can, in conclusion, while the regression controls the income and age, it do not account for the fact that different people have different saving preference, right? Individuals preference for saving, right? A different word, a different taste of saving. Even within given income and rate and age categories. So people tend to be saver. You tend to have both 400K as well as individuals retirement account. This means that the added term here is positively correlated with the P401K. And we also to know that for a given person, if a person participates in a 401k, does it make it less likely or more likely that the person also have an individual retirement account? And this ceteris paribus question is difficult to answer by OLS without many more controls for the individual's preferences of saving. So the variable E400K is a binary variable equal to one if a worker is eligible to participate in a 400K plan. And now we discuss what is required for E400K to be a valid instrumental variables for the P401K. The first, we need E401K to be partially correlated with the P401K. The regression verifies that they are strongly positively correlated, right? Yeah. The regression verify there is strongly positive correlated. The two variables are strongly positively correlated. 0.689. And not surprisingly that is being eligible for here's E400K is eligible to participate in a 400K by definition is necessary for participation. The more difficult issue is whether E400K can be taken as the exogenous in the structural model. In other words, is being eligible for 401k correlated with the earned observed taste of saving or individuals' preference of saving. If we think workers that like to save for retirements will match up with the employers that provide vehicles for retirement saving, then the youth, yeah, and E400K would be positively correlated. And certainly we think that E401K is less correlated with yields than P401K. Now we estimate the reduced form for P401K and verify E401K has significant partially correlated with P401K and use the Heteros Cardasticity Robust Standard Error. And the reduced form equation is here. Here's the intercept 0.059 and coefficient of E401K is 0.689, right? And with the heteros cardasticity robust standard error, is 0.008, right? Approximately. And you can see that the T statistic is 86, right? So and its coefficient estimate implies that holding income and a fixed eligibility is in 400K increase the probability of participation in founded and K by 0.689, right? And so it can be concluded that is 400K passes one of the two requirements of an instrumental variables for the P401K, right? Now, when use E400K is used at the instrumental variables for the P400K, we get the structural equation with the heteros cardasticity robust standard error here. Here's the intercept minus 1.207. And here's the coefficient of the P400K, 1K is 0.021. And you can compare the estimate of beta 1 from the structural equation by IV with the OLS estimate. So we compare with the OLS here. And you can see that here's the 0.021. 0.021. Here's the 0.054. So it is concluded that the IV estimate the IV estimate B 400 NK is less than half. It's just a half of the OLS estimates. And the IV estimate has the t statistic. The P400NK is 1.62 approximate. 1.62. We compare already as the final section. We test the hypothesis that P400NK is in fact exogenous using a heteros cardiosity robust test. You can see that after the obtain the reduced form residues, the reduced form residues from the first day of the reduced form, and we add the residue to the structural equation and run the OS, the coefficient. So the coefficient on the residues residue on the reduced forms is 0.075 approximate. 0.075, and with the t statistic and with the heteros cardiosity robust is the t statistic is 3.9, right? Therefore, there is a strong evidence that P400NK is endogenous in the structural equation. And of course, assuming that the IV instrumental variables E401K is exogenous, right? Thank you for listening.